Good evening, everybody. My name is Tom Aird. I'm the assistant principal here at the middle school. And on behalf of Ms. Keegan, I'd like to welcome all of you here to our 7th grade spring concert. As I told you back in the winter concert, I always look forward to seeing the progress that the kids have made from the winter through the springtime into 7th grade. It really is incredible, and I'm sure you'll see that tonight. There's a couple people here I'd like to acknowledge. First of all, our superintendent of schools, Dr. Pino Solano. Our board of education trustee, Mrs. Jim Benares. And all of you, thank you very much for coming. We really do appreciate your support and your help, and it's evident by the large crowd and the big group of chorus kids, which we'll hear from in a moment. And I'd just like to remind all of you that on May 16th is the budget vote, so please come out and vote on the budget, and I hope you enjoy the show. I'd like to introduce at this time, though, the most important person for our music program, and that is the director of our music in the district, Ms. Anissa Arnold.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to our first spring concert here at Herricks Middle School. I know you're all just as excited as I am to hear all the great music that's in store for you tonight. Watching these kids change through the years and just get better and better every time. Just when I think how great it is, it just is better. So I'm very proud of all the students you're going to hear tonight. A couple of quick things just to share about what's happening in the music department here at Herricks as a whole. A lot of great things are happening all the time, but just some things to point out. This year, for the 5th consecutive year, Herricks was named one of the best communities for music education in the country. So we're very proud. And another thing coming up this summer, we have a summer music program. This is our 8th year of this program, very, very successful. I know many of the students you're going to hear tonight have been involved in this program. So you've probably received an email from me throughout the last few months, but there's still some room in our program. It's in July, from July 5th through 28th. We meet at Herricks High School. It's for students in grades 4 through 9. So that involves all of you here. So if you're looking to continue to develop your musical skills over the summer, it's a great place to be. We'd be happy to have you join us. The link for the registration is on the Herricks website, so please feel free to check that out. And if you have any questions, you can either ask me or your child's music teacher. And there was one more thing, and yes, concerts. There are a lot of concerts here because we have such phenomenal musicians at Herricks. So I want you to check the calendar. You probably received an email from me. We have a concert on Monday, the 6th grade, and then on Thursday we have the 8th grade, and then on the 22nd we have a high school concert, and on the 24th, very important, we have the high school honors ensembles are performing at Malloy College. It is a great venue if you've never been there, and bring your children there. It's good to see what's coming your way when you get to high school. And the last concert I want you to know about is our final concert of the year. June 9th is our annual alumni jazz concert. You may be thinking, well, my child doesn't play jazz. It doesn't matter, because it's a night out in the courtyard of the high school. Sit back, listen, you can bring your young children. I bring my young son, he runs around, and there's ice cream and there's cookies, and it's just a great night out to be with your friends. So definitely check that one out. So I know that was a lot of information, and I don't expect you to remember all of it, but it's all on the district calendar, and your teachers also can help you out with that. So without further ado, it is my honor and pleasure to introduce our fabulous 7th grade chorus under the direction of our wonderful conductor, James Ludwig. Enjoy the concert.
We will be exploring different styles of singing by performing 4 very different pieces of music for you.
The first is called Ritorni al nostro cuore.
This piece is from an opera called Salustia by the composer Pier Golisi.
This song is almost 300 years old.
In it, you will hear our upper voice singers singing in what is called head voice. This means we're singing in our upper register.
The high highest note in this piece is an F, but sometimes in our warm-ups, we go all the way up to a high C. We hope you enjoy.
Ritorni al nostro cor.
By three students. Here they are.
Hello, my name is Brian.
I'm Elise Nagia.
And I'm Michaela Hill.
Next song is from Scotland. A lot of the song is no words at all, but uses phonemes.
These are sounds that don't have a meaning, but they just sound cool.
This song is a part of a tradition in Celtic music called lilting or portobello, which means tunes from the mouth.
This music might be sung during weddings, dances, or when doing chores around the house, or just for fun.
There are even competitions between portobello singers.
Because it is a folk music, we learn most of this song by ear.
But we also spend time learning to count 16 notes in order to master the complicated rhythms.
In this piece, you will hear us sing in our chest voices or our lowest, or our lower register.
We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. is Justin Marcello. Our next song will be very familiar to many of you. Can't Buy Me Love was an early hit for the Beatles, and when we sing it tonight, you'll have a chance to hear both our upper and lower voice sections by themselves.
That last bit of choreography they came up with this afternoon, and they asked me to do it, so we did it. Thank you again for coming. Our last piece will be introduced by two more students.
Hi, my name is Emily Shaw.
And I'm Casey Moon. For our last song, we'll sing a traditional African-American spiritual, Ain't Gonna Let Nobody Turn Me Around.
No one knows who wrote the song or where it came from originally. But it was first recorded in 1924 by the Fisk Jubilee Singers. It became really popular in the 1960s as a song during the Civil Rights Movement.
And this piece will sing in three-part harmony, and will also sing in a three-part ostinato before the climax. Ostinatos are repeated musical patterns that can layer on top of each other.
Thank you for joining us tonight. We have loved singing to you and appreciate so much of your support.
Before we finish, I just want to thank our accompanist, Michael Hagler, for helping us out with that. And as Mr. Aaron said at the beginning, really seeing them, seeing the seventh graders grow is such an extraordinary thing. And today in our rehearsals, they were really making some spectacular music during this last piece here. And so they really turned into the eighth grade choir of the future this afternoon. So here is Ain't Gonna Let Nobody Turn Me Around.
Talking, marching.
before we continue with our orchestra, I'd just like to take a minute to introduce our Music Boosters Association. As many of you are aware, we have a wonderful group of parents at Herricks that help support the music program and our music students. So I'd just like to introduce the president of Music Boosters, Mrs. Ellen Sinelli.
Some of the things that we did this year were we ordered Disney t-shirts for the Disney trip, which was very important because it contributed to the safety of the group. Our next big fundraiser is a Mets game that we have at City Field September 24th, where the chorus is performing. So if you would all like to purchase tickets to the game, anybody that purchases a ticket before June 1st, you're entitled to a voucher for a free ticket for the season. So we look forward to you getting in touch with us. Thank you.
If you are interested in purchasing tickets, I believe they're out on the table in the lobby, so on your way out, feel free to stop by and say hi. So it's my pleasure now to introduce our seventh grade orchestra. It's a very special group because I am so lucky that I was their teacher last year. So I am so proud of this group, and I'm so honored to pass them on to a wonderful, wonderful teacher, Ms. Weiss. And I'd like to introduce our seventh grade orchestra and our conductor, Ms. Weiss. Enjoy.
Hi, I'm Rhea and I'm a first violinist.
Hi, my name's Aisha and I'm a second violinist.
Our first piece is Overture to Alcina by George F. Handel. This overture is a part of Handel's most popular operas.
This is a very elegant sounding piece that transitions into a more upbeat tune.
This composition involves a title character named Alcina. Alcina is a sorceress who turns her lovers into rocks, streams, and wild beasts.
Quickly want to thank our conductor and teacher, Ms. Weiss, for all her help along the way.
We hope you enjoy Overture to Alcina.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Leonardo Gomez, and I play first violin.
And my name is Giorgio Sumperiotis, and I play bass.
We have changed the order of our pieces, so our next piece will in fact be Russian Sailor's Dance from the Red Poppy Ballet.
This piece was composed in 1927 and was the first Soviet ballet with the modern revolutionary theme.
The Russian Sailor's Dance is the most famous dance from this ballet, and is sometimes referred to as the Dance of the Sailors from the Soviet ships.
We are sure you will be able to visualize the rough and rowdy sailors. Most of the melodies were portrayed by the cello and bass section.
We hope you enjoy this piece. Thank you.
Good evening.
My name is Chris Anakis, and I play the violin.
And my name is Mary Agnes, and I play the viola. Our next and last piece is Shut Up and Dance.
You mean Get Up and Dance?
Hey, Chris.
Yeah?
Did I invite you to my barbecue?
No. Why?
Then why are you getting all up in my grill?
Hilarious. Anyway, this piece is arranged by Larry Moore, and you may even hear it on the radio sung by Rock the Moon. I can guarantee this piece will get you dancing up out of your seat.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy the rocking beat of our final piece, Get Up and Dance.
Yes, I always like to call this piece Get Up and Dance because that's actually one of my favorite things to do. As they know, they've seen me countless silly dancing times. So thank you. I have some really special people to thank. These two people right in the front row, Jeffrey Stone and Stephanie Lanuto. Please give them a huge... They have been teaching these a lot of these students sectionals this year, so they have just been doing an amazing job, so thank you so much. It's greatly, greatly appreciated, and amazing colleagues. And thank you to Ms. Arnold for sending me these wonderful children that she had last year and brought so far. And most of all to these students, because they're completely and utterly awesome. They have just been a pleasure to work with, both groups, all year long, and I can't wait to continue this next year with them. So let's get up and dance. Thank you.
And one more round of applause for our orchestra team. Welcome back. We are ready to conclude our concert tonight with our outstanding seventh grade band. I don't know about you, but I think we've heard phenomenal musicians tonight. Can we give everyone a round of applause? I'd also like to recognize all of our music teachers that are here tonight, both on the stage and in the back helping out. Congratulations to all of our teachers. We have such a great department with great dedicated staff, so thank you to all our teachers. I'd also like to recognize an important person you may not see, and that is Dave up in the sound booth for our light, sound, and videography tonight. So Dave. I hope you enjoyed our concert, and I hope to see you at some future concerts this spring. And it's my great pleasure to introduce the 7th grade band and Alicia Brown.
The hoedown, an American folk dance and square dance. We hope you enjoy our performance of these dances.
last piece is John Williams in Concert, arranged by Paul Lack. This piece is totally jawsome. There are many themes in this piece, such as Jaws. This part of the song is really cool because the low brass adds a feel of tension. It also includes the main tune from NBC News' mission theme, The Olympic Spirit, and some melodies from Star Wars. We really like this piece because anyone can just come along to it. We hope you enjoy the piece, and may the force be with you.
We get another really big round of applause.
Show that as well. They had a lot of fun learning this piece. You'll see that this was definitely their favorite in the way that they play it. But again, I really enjoy them. I'm very proud of all their hard work. I pushed them very hard. I told them I was on the verge of like, if I had a chance to do it again, maybe I would have gone easier. But as you can tell, they're doing amazing. So I'm very proud of them. They should be very proud of themselves. Thank you to all the parents for all of your support and your encouragement at home practicing. I'm sure when you heard that cluster piece, you were like, oh god. So I hope it made more sense tonight for you. So again, thank you so much for coming tonight. Thank you for your support. Have a great evening.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for all of our musicians tonight. Thank you all so much for coming. I hope you enjoyed our concert and hope to see you at more events in the future. Have a wonderful evening. See you soon. Parents, excuse me, please wait just a moment till the band is dismissed. Just stay in your seats till the band is dismissed. Keep the hallway clear. Thank you so much. Just one more moment. I appreciate your patience. You can meet your students in the gym.